This is the C.C.Jensen Offline Fine Filter HDU 2727. This is one of the core products in the C.C.Jensen filter line, and it's a modular setup, so a lot of configurations can come using the same 2727 filter insert. I'll just talk about the smaller unit here, the base unit, and walk you through the system components and give you an idea how the oil travels through this unit. Starting here, we have the suction port. That's connected to the system pump, which is located in the bottom here. The motor driving it can be equipped in a variety of voltages to suit your system. So the oil travels through the pump towards the filter housing. As it does, it will pass this port, which is a pre-filter sample port. This particular one has a handle valve on it, so you can turn the valve to take an oil sample. This makes a very convenient and consistent place to take an oil sample that you can send in for lab analysis. From there, the oil is pushed into the base of the filter housing and it will proceed to fill this area with oil around the filter cartridge. In your filter housing, you may have a variety of components. In the accessory port, you may have a pressure transducer like this, which is often used with a variable frequency drive to control the pump flow, or you may have a pressure switch, which is typically connected to the motor starter, so in the event of a high pressure situation, it will trip the unit out or trigger an alarm. Once the oil enters the filter housing, it comes in contact with the filter insert, which is inside. The oil is pushed from the outside of the filter through the media and goes down through the core, where it is then connected to the filter outlet. The way it's set up here, this happens to be on the back of the filter housing, and you can see the outlet port here, which is tapped directly to the core of the filter insert. This is the drain valve, located near the filter outlet. This is the way that you'll empty the filter housing when you're going to do a filter change. As the oil fills the filter housing, it will come from the bottom up and it'll be pushing the air out. This is the air vent screw, so you can crack that to bleed the air out. Once the oil starts to weep out of that, you can close it off and you know the filter housing is full. In place of the air vent screw, you may also have the C.C.Jensen automatic air vent, which is an option. This takes the place of the screw and has a float inside with a needle valve, so as the oil comes up inside the air vent, it will raise the float, close off the needle valve, so it's venting out the perfect amount of air. Once it's completely full of oil, it will close off. Also on the top, we have the pressure gauge. This is measuring the pressure that's pushing against the filter insert, so this will give you an indication of your filter loading. Typically, we'll include an overlay that will be adjusted to where you'll expect to have to change the filter. The top nut is removed in order to change the filter. You may have a nut like this with a lifting eye, or you might have the more common standard flush nut, depending on your setup. So that's an overview of the HDU 2727 offline fine filter. If you're interested in more information about it, or you'd like to see what a particular configuration would look like for your system, please get a hold of us. You can look in the links below, and we'd love to help you out.